Hello and welcome to this brief tutorial on using Rclone with Google Drive. This video will focus on its use at the University of Utah on gcloud.utah.edu, but is also applicable to any Google account, including personal accounts. There are limitations on the data that can be stored on Google Drive. As of November 2017, only public information can be put on Google services per Information Security Office policies. If you need to store protected health information or personally identifiable information, you'll need to find an alternative. Always check for updated policies to see which are available and what you can store on which services. Google Drive has unpublished limits on the amount that can be uploaded in a day. Currently, in late November of 2017, this stands at 750 gigabytes uploaded in 24 hours. You can make sure you do not exceed this limit by manually limiting the bandwidth in Rclone with the BW limit flag. To upload 750 gigabytes a day, for instance, use --BW limit equals 8M for 8 megabits per second. The limit will reset after 24 hours and the process will continue seamlessly if you haven't exceeded this arbitrary limit. There's also currently a limit of about 2 files per second, so transfers with a large number of files will be much slower than you might expect. If at all possible, create archives of some number of the smaller files, if not all of them, to prevent running into problems with the upload. To begin, let's go to the University of Utah's own Google Drive instance, which can be found at gcloud.utah.edu. You can sign in by clicking the login button, which will take you to the University of Utah's login site. I'm already logged in, but normally you would have to sign in with your university ID and password and go through Duo for two-factor authentication. You'll notice it opens up Gmail. To get to Google Drive, you click these dots in the top right-hand corner and click Drive. This should be familiar if you've used Google Drive before. You can create files and upload files here if you'd like, but later we're going to go over the command line tool Rclone to do that. To configure Rclone, you can run Rclone config. And you'll want to create a new remote by typing N. You can give this a name. You should probably choose something short because you'll need to type it many times. So I'm going to use gcloud. And there's actually an option for Google Cloud Storage, but this is not what we want to use. You can see in the parentheses here, it says this is not Google Drive. So we actually want to use the number 9 Google Drive option, even though we just went to gcloud.utah.edu, and that can be a bit confusing. But I will type 9 here for Google Drive and hit enter. You can leave this field blank and this, and go ahead and say yes to autoconfig. So I'll type Y and enter. Since I'm already logged in with my University of Utah account, I have my own account here, but you can also use your own account if you want to use your personal Google account, for instance. So you'll want to allow it to view and manage the files in your Google Drive. And it said it was successful. So if I go back here, I will choose no for a team drive, and it will give me the option to confirm the options that I've set, and I will do that and then quit the configuration. Now if I run Rclone list remotes, you can see gcloud, which is the remote I created at the beginning of this tutorial, and that is my only remote at the moment, though you can add others if you want to have multiple Google accounts associated with Rclone on CHPC resources. If you're using Windows or Mac, it's also possible to use Google Drive's desktop utility So I'm going to go to gcloud.utah.edu again and sign in. And this time I will need to enter my password. I changed computers here. I'm on a Mac now. So you'll want to sign in. And I have two-factor authentication enabled, excuse me. And I'll return to Google Drive. To download the tool to do this, you'll want to click the settings icon in the top right hand corner and click download drive file stream for Mac. Click the download for Mac button, or for Windows, depending on which operating system you're using. There's currently no support for Linux. And this will open in your downloads. Open the .pkg file. It should prompt you since you downloaded this file from the internet. Indeed, it did. So I will click continue. And it will run the setup wizard. This process is much the same on Windows, so I'm not going to show it twice. It's a pretty straightforward menu here, but you will need to be an administrator on your computer to install this. It will ask me to sign in here. So my username is my university ID at gcloud.utah.edu. Not gmail.com, like most personal email addresses are. And this will take me to the University of Utah's sign-in page, where I will sign in here. And you'll need to allow it to access your account information and manage your files on Google Drive. And this will only work for one account. So if you have a personal account and a University of Utah account, you can only have one associated with Google Drive file stream. So if you already have this set up with your personal account, you won't really be able to add another account without first removing your old one. So it's now been mounted on my computer here. If you look on the left side of this Finder window, it's under Devices, and I can see all of my files and directories that were on Google Drive before in Finder now. So if I wanted to copy a file over, I could just do so directly as if it were another file on my computer. And this looked like it copied very quickly. This is actually quite a large file. But if I go to Google Drive, you'll notice it's not here. And even if I try to refresh the page, it won't appear immediately. So even though it says it's copied over on my computer, it actually isn't present on Google Drive yet. It hasn't finished uploading. So this generally isn't a good idea to use file stream for very large files. You probably want to use Rclone, just so you can know the status of it and pick up where you left off. But you can see here it has now copied over and it's finished uploading. I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions, you can send us an email at issues@chbc.utah.edu or stop by our offices in INSCC 405. Thanks for watching.